first to talk about that we're here. It's been so long coming from an idea now to an institute. What does it feel like to be here, and what does this mean for Missouri?
It is so exciting. We announced this at a Board of Curators meeting, the establishment of NextGen on September 21st, 2018. And now we're here, a little more than 3 years, and we are completed and we are under budget. And we're excited about the possibilities of this incredible facility to help improve and save lives in Missouri and beyond.
And to fund these research projects, back in 2017, the UM system asked for $150 million from the state for a redevelopment plan that included the early version. We only have gotten, a total UM system has gotten about $27 million. And in past reporting from the Missourian and KOMU, UM officials said that they didn't expect all that money up front, and it was a stepping stone.
That's right.
So if you didn't expect that funding, was the plan to borrow money all along through a revenue bond?
Well, the plan was to build a building, and whatever means that we had available to complete this building, we needed to take that risk because it was that important, not only for improving healthcare in the state, but also improving the research as an AAU institution. And yes, thus far we've received $27 million from the state, but just this year the state has committed $10 million permanently as part of our appropriations to support not just the building, but the continuing research. So we're very, very happy with the support from the state.
And to go back with what you said, President Choi, about to do anything you could to get this institute up and running. For a lot of people, they don't know what precision health is.
That's right.
The individualized treatments, what that all looks like. You know, why put all of that effort in to build an institute? We talked to some politicians who said that the UM system has put everything out on the table for this. So this has been the highest priority, you've said, since, I'm going to say 2017, when you first looked at that redevelopment plan.
That's
why
right.
Put so much on the line for research that might not come in for 10 to 15 years?
Actually, the research that we are doing on precision health is paying dividends now. And many people know about our nuclear research reactor, and this facility will leverage the incredible work that's being done to develop the isotopes that are going to be used for the most advanced treatment for cancer. And the facilities that are at MIR right now are creating the types of isotopes that without them in North America, there will be many people whose lives will be at risk. And so our goal is to develop new isotopes in partnership with researchers at NextGen to create treatments for breast cancer and prostate cancer and other types of ailments that Missourians face. In addition to that, the research that we have in partnership with the VA to develop better treatment for PTSD and developing techniques to determine early signs of traumatic brain injuries are research that is paying dividends right now. But we know that the future holds great promise for even better treatment for our Missourians and veterans throughout the country.
And when we're talking about the building, obviously the Precision Health Initiative is system-wide, ideally getting campuses involvement on all four campuses. Why an institute here at MU, and why not renovate an old space?
Great question. Let me think about that a little bit. And the reason that we decided to make this signature investment in Columbia is because Mizzou is an AAU institution, and we needed to demonstrate through our research and commitment to healthcare that we are making the investment that will elevate our performance in AAU. And during the past 3 years, while we were constructing the building, we were able to attract top researchers from universities around the country that are going to come to this university and make their mark in developing the type of federal NIH, NSF, and DOD projects that will elevate our performance in research, while at the same time taking that bench to bedside approach of having the practical applications come true. So we're very excited that this building has taken foothold right here in Columbia.
And we've talked to health professionals who say precision health is the next step in medicine. And so Missouri and the UM system is taking that next step. But obviously a large part of that is getting those federal grants. And that part brings in some revenue for both the university and for an opportunity for researchers. How is the UM system going to guarantee that they get in federal grants? And part of that was that the building is now named after a federal legislator, Roy Blunt. So how does that all play into getting federal grants?
It is. And the investments that we made in this facility with the instruments and the faculty members that will be joining this facility from around the campus as well as around the country are already paying dividends. And the dividends are seen through the research proposals that we're submitting at the federal level. And during the past 5 years that this building has taken shape, we've seen almost an 80% increase in our federal research proposals. And that is a leading indicator. So we're very confident that the research expenditures will follow. But we're not going to be resting on our laurels. We're going to be catalyzing even more research and accelerating it by making the investments that are needed in areas such as precision health.
What does everything look like if everything goes right?
If everything goes right, this facility will be teeming with researchers, both faculty, staff, and students, who are singularly focused on developing the next revolutionary steps to treat diseases using a very precise approach. And to have that approach be implemented in practical applications that can be brought to market so that we can make an impact on the patients both in Missouri and in the nation. We want to create the next Therasphere or the next Lutathera right here in this space, and so that we can continue to make an impact in precision health.
And what makes Missouri different?
What makes Missouri different is that we are one of the few universities that have on a single campus School of Medicine, Engineering, Vet Medicine, and Ag and Food and Natural Resources. But when you combine the nuclear research reactor, we are a unique institution. Now we can leverage the strengths of those facilities with the intellectual firepower that we have in our faculty members to make new discoveries possible. And there's no other university that can have that type of focused infrastructure and the intellectual firepower for us to make a difference in clinical settings that benefit Missourians and beyond.
Well, we're talking about intellectual firepower. When day one happens on that ribbon cutting on Tuesday, will this institute be in full swing, or is it going to take a while for things to ramp into place?
I would say that this facility will begin with very exciting research on immunotherapy and radiopharmaceuticals. But we also have laboratories that are set aside to recruit new faculty from around the campus, around the system, and around the country, so that we will see an evolution of activities in this space.
The UM system planned to hire 60 principal investigators, 30 from already within the system and 30 outside hires. Do you have an update on that number? I know in September it was about 36 had been already approved.
That's right. And if we look at the number of faculty members who have been hired as part of NextGen beginning in 2017, there are over 50 faculty members that have been hired. And they are in various departments across the university and the system. And it's important to recognize that NextGen is not just this building. NextGen is a campus-wide, system-wide effort that involves faculty members who are going to be working in different parts of the university. Not necessarily in this building, but with this singular focus to advance precision health.
So if not everyone's working in the building, why build the building?
This building is that center point. And even though there are faculty members and researchers that are working outside of this building, they'll rely on the instrumentation, the MRIs, and the electron microscopes that only this building can provide.
And the last question we have set right now is, obviously, if this is a campus-wide initiative and it spans far beyond that, with precision health, it's all about personalized patient treatments and the data storing of that. How exactly is the UM system planning on storing data and getting that to, be accessible across all campuses?
So that storage of data is a critical need, not only for our university, but universities throughout the United States. And it's very important for us to use the most advanced storage protocols and safety protocols so that we can have that in a secure fashion. What is great about this university is that we have a strong partnership with Cerner. And as part of our Tiger Institute opportunities, we have been working for the past decades in securing medical records in a very secure and safe fashion. So we will continue with that approach.